I hope you all are fit and fine. Welcome to our value education class. Today we are going to study lesson number 6, teamwork leads to success. Okay children, so open your textbooks, page number 25 and lesson number 6. Now let us read the moral of the lesson. Individually we are just one drop each. Together, we are an ocean. Children, here in today's session, we are going to learn about the value of working together. Okay, children? Now, what is teamwork? Teamwork is many people when working together forms a teamwork. Okay, children? And what is a team? A group of people or group of objects when come together, they form a team. And that is where when this team is working together, we call it as teamwork. And whenever we do a teamwork, good teamwork, okay, then that leads to success. If you are not working together or in a teamwork, then you will not achieve your success. You will be failed to complete that task. Okay, children? Now, children, I would like to share with you the example of our school also. Here, in a classroom, suppose now you are in class 5th, okay? All teachers, to run your class, all teachers have to do their teamwork to teach you, okay? You are learning different subjects, maths, science, Hindi, Marathi, value education, physical education, like that, okay? If one of the teacher is not working, then what will happen? That subject is affected, okay? You will not be able to work properly or learn properly in that subject. It means that suppose that subject is not studied properly by you, okay? Then you have complained regarding that subject. Okay, children? So, even if you are working in a group competition also, there also you should work. When you are working in the groups, you have to show a proper teamwork. Suppose you are playing on the ground, okay, basketball, and you are having your team, okay? If 2-3 players are not playing properly, will you win the game? No, because you are not doing the proper teamwork there. Okay, children, if you are doing a proper teamwork, then that will lead to victory or your success that time. Okay. Now, like that, children, we have the importance of teamwork, and we should learn to develop the spirit of teamwork, and you should understand and value the capabilities of others also. Okay, children? Now, children, you all know that that thought, that is unity is strength. Okay, that means ekta mein shakti hai. Okay, when united we stand, that leads to our success. Okay? And there is one more other saying, that united we stand and divided we fall. Okay? Whenever there is, we have to stand for something or for doing something or work for something, we should be standing united. And when we are falling, that times we get divided, okay? So individually we are just, it is said that individually we are just one drop each, and together we are an ocean, okay? If many drops come together, means drop means, you know, it is a single water, okay, single unit of that water, okay, when that will come together, we can form a ocean also, if that has come together, okay. Like that, if you are individual, then you are only one unit, and if you are together, then you are like a team, okay, and you should form a good team whenever you do any activities, okay. Now let us read the question. You are brilliant in maths. There is a maths inter-school competition in the individual and team categories. You can win the individual prize, but your class will not win if you are not with them. What do you do? Take part in the team category? Take part in the individual category. Which option do you think is correct, children? Yes, the first option is correct. So take it, okay? Take part in the team category. Now, children, let us read the story, okay? This story tells us that if we pool in our effort and work as a team, victory will always be ours. This is what the ants did. Read on to see how they win. Now, the title of the story is Teamwork. The day finally arrived. Every insect in the garden had been training hard for the great balloon competition. The balloon competitions were always something special, since they could only happen after the children of the house had celebrated a big party. Now, on that one day, or that day has arrived where there is going to be a great balloon competition, okay? And every insect was waiting for that. And these competitions were held always for something special, and since they could only happen after the children of the house had celebrated, okay, in the big party, okay. Now let us see what happens in the story, children, further. So let us read further. Each time the flying insects won the competition because they could grab the balloon strings and fly off in all directions, creating all sorts of patterns in the air. However, this year, a group of ants was also taking part. Of course, no one expected that they'd do anything special. They were so light. Now here, children, what has happened, what we have read, we have seen that each time the flying insects were winning the competition, okay, of this balloon, and they used to take that balloon or grab that balloon string and fly off in all directions. They used to create their own patterns, okay, in the air. And however, now this time, who is going to take part? A team of ants, okay, or the group of ants. What is the group of ants also called in other words? It is called as army, okay, army of ants was also taking part, and no one expected that they will do something special or anything special because they were light in weight also, and even they could not fly. Other insects are thinking about the ants like this, okay, children. Now let us read further. Finally, the competition began. As always, the butterflies and the fireflies left everyone amazed with their twists and turns and their wonderful colors. Next came the ants. Now, here children, the competition had begun, and the butterflies and fireflies had done their with the competition of balloon, and they had shown their twists and turns and their wonderful colors. And now it is whose turns, children? Whose turn is there? Now the ants are going to show their skills. Okay, come to the next page, children. They shared just one balloon among them. One by one, they climbed up the balloon string, forming a thin black thread of ants. When the entire string was covered, the last ant climbed over his teammates to reach the balloon. Once there, he climbed to the top of the balloon and then pierced the balloon with all his might, using his sharp mandibles. Now, dear children, all the ants shared just one balloon, okay? And one by one, they started climbing the balloon string, and they form a black thin thread of ants over that string, okay? And covered the entire string. And what did the last ant did? She climbed over his teammates and reached the balloon, okay? And once he climbed to the top of the balloon, he pierced the balloon with all his mandibles, okay, sharp mandibles. And then a sound comes, shuck, phat. The balloon began blowing up out its air, flying madly about, while the ants made some perfectly synchronized beautiful designs out of the string. The originality and the teamwork of ants won them the first prize. From then on, in that garden, everyone understood that how much could be achieved by working together. Now here, children, when the ant has pierced a sharp mandibles into that balloon, the balloon began blowing out its air and flying madly, okay, wherever it can go, okay. Then with that string, the ants formed a beautiful design, and it was synchronized, means it was in a proper coordination, okay. And they formed a beautiful patterns and designs, and this made, or this originality and teamwork of ants made them to win the first prize in this competition. And from then on, in that garden, everyone understood that we should always work together to achieve success. Okay, children? Now, what have we learned from this lesson, children? We have learned that we should understand that single-handedly only certain tasks can be established. But as a team, much more work can be done. Okay? Children, teams are formed for a common purpose, and the members work together towards a common goal. Children, whenever you work on large projects or undertaken in the classroom situations, such as preparing for great celebrations like PSBID's Day or Annual Day or your sports day, teamwork is undertaken and it works well. Even during the events when you do a teamwork, it works well, children. And teamwork ensures that different members of a group work harmoniously, or you yourself should show that you are working in a synchronized manner, or in a proper coordination, or you are working in a harmonious way. Okay, continuously and smoothly you are working when we are doing a teamwork. Okay, and teamwork enables you to accomplish the task easily. Okay, if suppose you are doing working for some event, if you are working alone, then it becomes very hard for you to work. But when you are working together, then it becomes very easy, children. Okay, now children, when you are doing teamwork, you should have, or teamwork requires mutual respect and understanding between the team members. Okay, there should be a mutual understanding and mutual respect for each other whenever you do a teamwork. Okay, like I have done this much work, why should I do? That is not correct way when you are doing a teamwork. Okay, or you at times say that I am not capable of that, doing that. When you are in a team, you should do equally, mutually and even respectively, and you should have mutual understanding when doing your teamwork, okay, within your team members. Okay, children. Now, collective efforts result in achieving success. Whenever you are showing your collective efforts, group efforts, that gives us success. Okay, directly. And children, here also we have learned in the story of teamwork that how the ants worked as a team and won the show, and they were had become the hero of that day. Okay, now children, here I have come to the end of our session. Thank you.